boat in the water, there's algae out there. And I'm sure it's affecting the restaurants.
More blue-green algae spreading down the Caloosahatchee and into North Fort Myers and Cape Coral. Tonight, there are new health alerts across Southwest Florida. NBC2's Rachel Whalen is live and local at JC Park off Southeast 20th Place, where the bloom has health officials telling people to stay away from the water.
We're seeing the usual crowd here at JC Park. People have been walking around here all day, but I want you to take a look at this sign that the city just put up. Now, it says there's nothing wrong with walking around here, but you should definitely avoid the water, especially make sure to keep your pets and kids away from it. It also tells you don't eat shellfish from this location and be very careful if you eat other fish.
They had an announcement and they showed JC Park and I went, oh no, because I walk here twice a day.
Suzanne Limehertz and her dog Sadie are regulars at JC Park, but just yesterday she noticed something a little different in the air.
My right sinus right now is all swollen. I can't hardly breathe out of the right side, so I know it's here because it just gets in the air and it sneaks up on you.
Blue-green algae is harmful if ingested and can irritate your skin. The Department of Health issued a blue-green algae alert for JC Park along the Caloosahatchee River. It also found algae in the Rubicon Canal, the Paradise Marina entrance, and the river's condo. Jo Harrison lives there. She says many people go out to their boats to grab a bite to eat, but lately,
nobody's put their boat in the water. There's algae out there. And I'm sure it's affecting the restaurants.
The Cape Harbor Oyster Bar is one of the few restaurants left with boat parking. But owner Heath Hinman says he's not worried.
We don't get a big, strong smell of it in here because we're behind the lock. Now, with the lock being gone in the hurricane, I still don't see it coming in. But if it does, we would just have the people come inside.
The city of Cape Coral is working to reduce blue-green algae blooms by activating bubble curtains during incoming tides. For now, some are changing their 4th of July plans.
We were kind of thinking about having a family picnic over here, but we decided not to.
The city is sending out a few reminders. As always, remember to clean up after your pets. Also, grass clippings and fertilizers that contain phosphorus and nitrogen can get into the water and make the blooms worse. That's why you're not allowed to use those fertilizers right now. I'm live and local in Cape Coral, Rachel Whalen, NBC2.
Just a heads up, call your